This is my boss, Jonathan Hart, a self-made millionaire. He's quite a guy. This is Mrs. H. She's gorgeous. She's one lady who knows how to take care of herself. By the way, my name is Max. I take care of both of them, which ain't easy. Because when they met, it was murder. Mr. H, I just can't get used to cars coming up my right. If you want, I'll take another stab at it.
Thanks, Max, but one stab was enough.
I'm really looking forward to meeting Sel William.
I think you and Billy might get along well.
He's got a bit of a reputation when it comes to women.
I thought he just got married.
No, remarried. His first marriage didn't fare too well.
Well, from what I hear, Claire's got everything going for her, including Billy's attention.
Billy's let it sound as if they were really happy.
Well, shouldn't be much further.
I sure hope there's some money on the hunt, because I'm betting Mrs. H all the way.
Oh, Max, I don't think they give odds on Fox Hunts.
Odd, isn't it?
Look out!
That was close.
Think how the fox was feeling.
They're getting worse.
And I'm not getting any sleep. See if you can compose yourself. Remember, we're expecting guests in the morning.
Sel William lives all the time.
No, Max, he has a townhouse in London. This is his weekend place.
He really knows how to enjoy his weekends. Oh, isn't this beautiful, darling?
It certainly is.
Hello. You must be Jennifer.
Yes,
Claire Belgrave.
How are you?
And this is Jonathan.
Jonathan?
How do you do?
How do you do?
And Max. Max?
How do you do, Lady Belgrave?
Well, we're very indebted to your husband. He was very gracious about this invitation.
Yes, I'm sure.
See you later, Mr. H. Right.
I'm delighted you could come. William's told me so much about you. Shall we go inside? Oh, darling, look!
The chestnut's Prince Valiant. You'll be riding him in the hunt.
Beautiful. This is a dream come true. The Belgrave Hunt is famous even in the States.
Well, it's a tradition my family's maintained for over 100 years.
Right through here. Oh, Claire, what a beautiful room.
Thank you. This table was given to Josephine by Napoleon.
Really?
Some of the family?
At least 3 generations of them. Come on, this way. William's out shooting. Jonathan, Jennifer, I realize this may sound a little strange, but over the next few days I may need your help.
Something wrong, Claire?
It's William.
Excuse me, Lady Belgrave. Sir William is expecting his guests.
Of course. Mr. and Mrs. Hart, this is Arthur Lovejoy, our estate manager.
How do you do?
Hello.
How do you do?
Hello, Arthur.
This way, please.
Ho! Oh. Ho! Oh.
Not bad. Get better. Come on.
Right, ho! Oh.
You're a little off to the right. Jonathan! Jennifer! How are you, Jonathan? It's good to see you again, Jennifer.
Billy?
Well, we're feeling fine and you're looking well.
Well, that's because I'm relaxing. That's what I'm best at. I see you've already met Claire.
Of course.
What do you say, Jonathan? £10 a toss?
Oh, come on. You wouldn't try to take advantage of me, would you?
Look at it this way. The exchange rate's in your favor.
Wish me luck.
I will. I just saw the way he shoots. Come and have a drink.
Come on, we'll choose a weapon for you. Ah, this looks a good one. Let's see. This gun is filthy. I've told you about this before. If these guns get jammed, they'll backfire and blow someone's head off. Let's see what we've got here. That's better. Load this. Come on, Jonathan.
I told you I haven't done this for a long time.
Oh, come on.
Thank you.
Ooh.
Told you I'm a little rusty.
I'm sorry I didn't call for £20 a toss.
That's never too late.
Well, you're the guest. £20 it is. Have another go.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Thank you. You know, Billy, I think it's coming back to me. Your turn.
I think I've been had.
Nobody's ever beaten you at your game.
Not yet, anyway. Pull!
This is the kitchen. Well, I have work to do. If you're hungry, Annie will find something for you. Do not feel free to help yourself.
Don't you be scared of Cyril. With all his airs and graces, you'd think he was the master of the house.
Don't worry, Annie. I've handled plenty of Cyrils in my time. This smell is the best smell I've smelled since I left home. What is it?
What, this?
Yeah. Oh,
this is tonight's supper. Yeah, I'll give you a taste if you like.
Oh, thanks, Annie. By the way, my name is Max. Don't tell anybody it's short for Maxwell.
Oh, well, I'm Annie. I'm very pleased to meet you, Maxwell.
I'm more than pleased to meet you, Annie.
This here is Sir William's favorite. Yeah.
Annie, that's fantastic. Why don't I set out a couple of wine glasses and you and I have dinner together?
Go on, I'm too busy anyway. I'll tell you what. You eat now and then later on, after dinner, we'll have some wine together then. All right, love?
All right, that's even better, Annie. Thanks. I can't wait to taste real English cookie. Hi, Cyril. How's it going, baby?
Just fine, thank you. Seems Lady Belgrave's had another nightmare.
Oh, yes. And it seems to me that some people should mind their own business.
Oh, thank you, Annie.
I believe Mr. Lovejoy has got himself into a state about something.
Oh, him. I reckon he thinks he ought to own this place. He's not content with just running it.
Annie, before I go home, you gotta give me the recipe for this. This is terrific.
Oh, well, the sauce, there ain't nothing to it, but it's getting the brains really nice and tender. That's the trick.
Brains? Can you spare one of those?
I guarantee you, Jonathan, Prince Valiant will be the best mount of the hunt. With Jennifer at his reins, it'll be a sight Brandy Brook will remember.
Billy, you're very kind.
I'm sure the fox will remember, too.
No fox anymore, Jonathan. We ride after a scent which has been dragged across the ground. The sport's the chase.
I'm all for that. No, thanks. It was a wonderful evening.
Oh, yes, thank you, Claire. It was lovely.
You've been awfully quiet tonight, Claire. Are you feeling all right?
Just a little tired, that's all.
Coffee, sir?
Please. Thank you, Cyril. Thank you, Annette. You all have to excuse Claire. With all the servants around here, she obviously tires easily watching them clean and cook for her.
If you'll excuse me, I have a slight headache. Will you be up shortly, dear?
I think I'll have a drop more brandy. I'll be up later. Why don't you run along? I'll be up soon.
I think we'll follow suit, Billy.
Yes.
Good night.
Billy.
Thank you. Billy, for a lovely dinner.
Good night.
Good night.
You got anything else?
I think I know what you're thinking.
You do? What's that?
That maybe Lady Claire Belgrave is a little strange, and that maybe you have second thoughts about riding Prince Valiant on the hunt, and that maybe we should pack up, get out of here, and go home.
Well, actually, I was thinking that maybe Lady Claire Belgrave isn't quite as strange as we thought, but I'm dying to ride Prince Valiant on the hunt, and maybe we shouldn't pack up, get out, and go home.
So I was pretty close.
Close?
Closer.
We can show you a bit of the countryside, and then we'll take a look at the first cover.
Hello, hello. All set? Fine day for it. Come and see Arthur's hounds. They are Dorset bloodhounds. He breeds them.
Hello.
Yeah, boy. Now, here. Give him something. Come on. It's hard to tell from looking at them, but one of those little grubbers can tear a man to shreds.
Ooh.
Right, we'll get started.
Right.
Hop. Hey! There we are.
Well, let's hope for a good ride today.
Where do you keep the foxhounds, Billy?
We don't keep them here at Brandy Brook. They'll be brought in on the day of the hunt.
How do you like it, Johnny?
Yes, Jennifer, what do you think of Prince Valiant, eh?
He's beautiful.
Fine. Let's ride.
Can't you see he's trying to kill me? How is she?
The doctor said it's just a slight sprain. He's setting a sling. Look, I hope you didn't let Claire scare you back there. She's been under a lot of stress recently. Drink?
No, thanks.
She seems terrified about something.
Oh, she's a thoroughbred. But of course, you don't believe that nonsense about my trying to kill her. She's been having nightmares. Frankly, I've been thinking about seeking psychiatric help for her.
Really? She seems perfectly lucid to me.
I think we'll give Claire a chance to get some rest. Peace and quiet could do her good. Jennifer and I will go down in the village and look around a little bit.
Good idea. You could probably use the diversion.
Where's Max?
Max, he's been spending a lot of time in the kitchen.
Well, you can get down to the kitchen that way.
Oh, fine, Billy. Well, we'll see you later.
Billy.
Bye.
Four aces.
Why are we going to the village?
Because we can't talk here. Too many eavesdroppers. Ah, Max.
Just a second, Mr. H. Five nines.
Eight nines. I'll call you.
I'll call. How many you got?
Two. So?
I got what?
You're five.
I ain't got any. That's why it's called liar's poker.
What about you, Cyril? But this is of little interest to me. Excuse me.
I'll give you a game later tonight.
You're right. Well, Mr. H, what's up? How's Lady Belgrave?
It's nothing serious, Max. Mrs. H and I are going to go into the village. We want you to come with us.
Oh, Mr. H, I'd love to. Thank you very much, but I made some other arrangements.
I'm ready, Maxwell. Oh.
Annie, you look wonderful.
Thank you, Maxwell.
Annie, may I present Mr. and Mrs. H? Mr. and Mrs. H, Annie.
Oh, good afternoon, madam. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
How do you do?
Annie promised to take me on a tour of the better saloons.
Pubs, Maxwell. Pubs.
Pubs.
Maxwell, what about the driving?
Oh, don't worry. I'm taking him.
She's taking me. Nice, huh? Well, Annie, come on. Let's partake of some British culture.
Oh. Enjoy yourselves. Maxwell.
Oh, it's kind of cute, isn't it? Let's get out. Would you like to sample some of the local brew?
Yes, please.
My favorite answer.
All right, you are the meat there. Come on. Go on, boy. That's it.
Morning.
Morning.
Morning, sir.
2 pints of bitter.
Nice day.
£1.40, sir.
We don't seem to be hitting it off too well, do we?
No, we don't.
Thank you, sir.
Mind if I play?
You only play for pints in here.
I'll play for pints.
I'll play him. Idiots.
How do you do, Eddie? I'm Jonathan Hart. This is my wife, Jennifer.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Don't pay no attention to the boys, Johnny. They don't take kind in new blood. Now, which would you like?
Well, these look nice.
How about some 101?
101? How about American style? Closest to the bullseye.
Sure, why not? After you. Here, hang on, you lot. It's you lot that should be buying Johnny a pint. Gripe all you like, but not one of you have the backbone to play me. I'll play you any time, Johnny. Oh, nice to meet a fellow with spirit. Tommy, 3 pints for me and my friends here.
We'll buy pints all around for everybody.
To the Yanks.
To the champ.
Cheers.
Cheers. Eddie, you're a man of many talents.
What brings you all the way out of nowhere, Johnny?
We came to ride in the Belgrave hunt.
Ah, guests aboard of Billy, are you?
You know him?
There's only one.
I suppose he has quite a reputation.
Reputation? I'll say he has. Mind you, he's got selective now. He likes some under 25.
That was the old Billy. He's married now. Surely he must have settled down.
Well, yeah. But it's all around the village that his missus is going to drop him like a red-hot brick. If she divorces him, she'll come out with a pretty penny, I can tell you. Tommy, another round, please.
Mr. and Mrs. H.
Max, hello.
Hi, Max.
Hello, Eddie.
How are you? Fine, thanks. See, you found a live one.
Not Yank, is it?
Well, as you all know each other, I'll go and practice.
Boy, you missed the excitement. There was quite a nasty scene at the house before we left.
What sort of a scene?
So William and Lady Belgrave really had a go at each other.
He was going on about her not knowing anything, not even how to shoot skeet. I swear, I thought he would kill her.
Here you are. Thanks a lot.
Do you think he'll really do it?
I don't know, darling. I don't want to wait around and find out. We'll be right back.
Come on, come on.
Misfired. It was an accident. Thank you so much for coming.
Lady Belgrave, I'm very, very sorry about Sir William's accident. I think that clears it up. I do appreciate your cooperation.
I appreciate yours, Inspector.
Jennifer and I have decided that it would be easier if we went back to London.
Jennifer, what about the hunt?
Claire, under the circumstances.
The circumstances are that this is the Belgrave Hunt. It's been run every year for over 100 years. It'll run this year as well.
Claire, wouldn't you prefer to be alone?
Alone's the last thing I need to be. Please, stay for me. This house, it's so big. Everything's so empty now. I really want you to stay.
Darling.
Well, on one condition. That you'll let me help you settle any problem you might have in tidying up Billy's affairs.
I'd be very grateful for that, Jonathan. Well, if you'll excuse me, it's been rather a long morning. I think I'll lie down for a while.
Of course.
You know, you're both so kind.
Don't you think there's been a significant change in Claire's attitude?
In this house, it's hard to tell the players without a scorecard.
Are you having problems with the car?
Neither, Eddie. Tommy at the pub told us where we could find you. I'd like to talk to you.
Sure. I'll just get rid of the bike.
Customer's coming to pick it up end of the week.
Bet you'll hear about Billy's accident.
If it was an accident.
Did I yank it out? Well founded, too.
You think so?
Do you think that Lady Belgrave could have been involved?
She had her reasons, mate. 2 or 3 million of them.
Hello, Arthur.
Hi.
It's 3 o'clock. Do you have Lady Belgrave's car ready?
I said I would. Keys are in there.
Hmm. I'll see you back at the house.
Yes, Mr. Lovejoy.
Problems with your engine?
Yes, it's fixed up fine now. Car's round the back, Arthur.
Right.
A real charmer, eh?
I still think you made a mistake. Should let the Harts go.
You're very sweet, Arthur. Not smart, but very sweet.
You're underestimating Jonathan Hart. He'd never have gone to London and let this rest.
What's his stake in all that?
No stake, it's what he's made of. One thing you can give Billy credit for, he knew how to pick his associates. Jonathan's sharp and persistent. He's also got a healthy curiosity.
Mm. Maybe not so healthy for him this time.
Now you're thinking along my lines. I want the Harts out of the way.
Another accident?
You'll think of something.
Something wrong?
You will take care of the Harts.
I think I can throw them off the scent.
You know, I couldn't have done this without you.
Just remember that, love.
More to say than I can trust to paper. Meet me at 9 o'clock at the old greenhouse.
You think that's from Eddie?
Maybe. Well, we have a little time before that.
What do you think?
I think that you should get ready for bed and I should go out and make the meeting.
Oh, no. Absolutely not. Whether thou goest, I followest.
Followest?
Mm-hmm.
There's no such word as that.
There is now. Okay?
Okay.
How does it happen, darling?
What?
How does it happen that two people fall in love, get married, and then wind up hating each other so much that they're willing to commit murder?
Maybe Claire and Billy were never in love. Maybe it was comfortable.
Comfortable? Hmm. I suppose people do get married just because it's comfortable. Promise me something. Promise me we'll never stay together just because we're comfortable.
I promise we'll never be comfortable.
No, that's not exactly what I meant.
What did you mean?
Well, I meant we should be comfortable. We just shouldn't just be comfortable.
I promise we'll never just be comfortable.
Good.
How am I doing now?
You're a lot closer.
Comfortable?
Oh, you rat.
Is it?
Oh.
5 minutes after nine. We'll wait another 5 minutes.
Okay. What's that? Sounds like the hounds of the Baskervilles.
Let's forget the next 5 minutes. We've got to get back to the house.
We'll never outrun them.
We can try. Come on. They won't follow us in the water. So much for man's best friend.
That theory about Billy's death being an accident's gone to the dogs.
We may need a little backup for the hunt tomorrow.
What are you planning?
To call in the cavalry.
Yes, sir. Good boy, thank you.
Just as I told you.
Don't worry, I'll see they're there. Just you get it right this time.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I, on behalf of all of us, say thank you to Lady Belgrave for inviting us here again today and keeping up the Belgrave tradition. And may I, at the same time, express our sympathy, Lady Belgrave, for your great loss in the death of Sir William.
Ask me tomorrow.
Oh, you'll do fine. Just watch your footing and keep an eye out for low branches.
Well, old Pip, what do you say?
Cheerio.
I'll be fine.
You go on.
Oh, no, we'll stay here away with you.
No, I insist you're Mr. Hunt.
I'll be along in a minute. Go on.
All right.
Just in the nick of time.
Not much good without the shot.
Can you handle her?
No problem, Johnny.
Arthur?
Arthur.
I'm a little disappointed in Arthur.
Why?
It would have been much more British if it had been the butler.
Oh. You've been practicing.
Come on, Eddie, now. Come on, boy.
I said I could go with my friend.
Yay! Yeah! Oh,
no. Your throw.
Bravo! That's the first time I've been beaten in 3 years. She's good.
Yes, she gets straight to the point.
Come on, I'll buy you a couple of beers.
We'll be over in a minute.
I want to talk to you.
You do? What about?
I didn't know you could do that.
Oh, well, you see, there are lots of things that you don't know I could do.
Want to give me some hints?
No, I want you to find them all out slowly.
There is one thing I know.
What's that?
Was I right?
Bullseye.